Hi, my name is Tamar Lawton, and I am the Elegant Savage. So, before we get started, guys, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button down below so you can become a part of the Elegant Savage fam, and also so you won't miss any of the new videos that I release. In this video, I will be giving you all a quick rundown of my natural hair journey. About a year and a half ago, I started growing my hair out, and I didn't really have any specific goals for my hair at the time, but my first cut was the south of France. And pretty much what the south of France is when you have a fro and you temp or basically fade out the sides, but you keep the front and the back. As my hair continued to grow, I started to think, like, how could I possibly like style my hair? I'm not the type of guy that wants to just have boring hair, you know what I'm saying? Not saying I would do anything crazy, but even when I was in middle school and high school, you know, I'd always do the 360 waves, you know what I mean? Not just the little ripples on the top, but the full like 360 waves that looks like someone dropped a pebble in the middle of my head and just spread out like deep waves. So eventually I settled with curls, and naturally, you know what I mean, when I decided to make that move, my first thought was, okay, I need to get a curl sponge just like everybody else. They're like, yeah, I probably need to get a curl sponge if I want to go with the curls. And so, you know, I got the curl sponge or whatever, and I actually did the curl sponge for about 13 months. And it was straight, you know what I mean? It had its ups and downs, but I never truly liked it, you know what I mean? Because all it was basically doing was gathering my hair together and kind of knotting it up, you know what I mean? But I'm not going to completely discredit the curl sponge. It did have its benefits. It allowed me to train my hair and get it used to curling in a certain direction. So if you go watch my curly hair routine, you know what I mean, the link for that will be in the description below. You'll see how I was shingling my hair and how I was saying that you need to move your hair in a certain direction, getting used to going in a certain direction. The curl sponge, you know, after I figured out which direction was best for me, the curl sponge allowed me to train my hair to get used to basically twisting in that direction. So like I said, after doing the curl sponge for a while, you know what I mean, it just wasn't cutting it for me, you know what I mean? It was doing a good job, but it wasn't actual curls. You could look at my hair and tell it was knots. Like now, if you look at my hair close, for instance, you can see this as I drop it back. These are curls, you know what I mean? You can easily, clearly see the curls right here versus, you know, when I used the curl sponge, it was just, you know, I like that. Let's get it. But versus when I used the curl sponge, you know what I mean, it was just knots. So you would pull it out and all the hair would be tangled together. Whenever I would try and detangle my hair, which if you don't know what that means, you need to watch my curly hair routine video. But yeah, whenever I would detangle my hair or try and put my fingers or like pick through my hair, it would be ridiculous. Like it would hurt so bad, it would be crazy. So, you know what I mean, eventually I got to a point where I needed a better routine. And so that's when I started researching different ways, like, okay, how can I efficiently curl my hair? And, you know what I mean, as I looked through YouTube, there wasn't too much at the time for, like, guys doing, like, curly hair. There's a little bit more out there because, you know what I mean, this particular hairstyle is trending now. You know what I mean, everybody's got the black power move going on, black fist emoji going crazy. But there wasn't a lot for men. You know, you type in a curl routine and, you know, it'd be mostly for women. Their hair, you know what I mean, generally is a little bit different. But I was able to pick up off of different things that they were doing to their hair and basically incorporate it into my routine. And eventually, you know what I mean, I found a good routine that doesn't take that long, and I do it once or twice a week, usually just once a week, and I'm fine. So that's pretty much my natural hair care journey, y'all. That's what I got into. Like I said, you know what I mean, I always wanted to find a style that, like I said, wasn't crazy, but it definitely fits like my personality. It keeps me looking stylish, you know what I mean? Because I do like having my style A1 at all times. And one last thing, guys, probably the biggest thing I almost forgot to put inside this natural hair journey is when I would say about the first year. So the first 12 months, whenever I would go to the barber shop, I was actually getting my hair trimmed. You don't want to do that and get it trimmed too much off the top because that's going to delay your growth. So I was wondering, my hair naturally grows slow. You know what I mean? That's just genetics. But it was growing even slower because I was constantly getting it trimmed like every 3 to 4 weeks. You know what I mean? So I was not getting any type of growth on my hair. So definitely do not trim it like that. You do want to do freehand trims, however, because you want to be able to catch. Freehand trims are when you pick your hair all the way out so it's straight. You want to use a detangler first, and they go over the top part of your head and get any loose ends or split ends or anything like that. When they do that, mixed hair, you know what I mean, tangles and all that good stuff. I mean, all that bad stuff, shit, all that bad stuff that may cause you to have to, like, you know, cut your hair and start over because you have dead hair. You're here. Girls talk about that all the time. And that is why, because, you know what I mean, if you had dead hair, like the loose ends, split ends at the ends start to die, then you'll have to basically chop, you know what I mean, chop your hair off. So you don't want that to happen. So take care of your hair, guys. I'll be here giving you all more tips on how basically I do it, how I keep it moist, you know what I mean, how I have girls coming up to me asking me, how do I keep my hair moist and how do I take care of my hair, you know what I mean? And definitely I would say one thing with this journey, it does give you a bigger perspective, or I guess it allows you to understand what some, like, basically most black girls go through, you know what I mean, when it comes to natural hair, because it's like, oh, now I know what they were saying when they're like, oh, the temperature or the humidity did such and such to my hair, because now that I have so much hair, you know what I mean, you talk about protective hairstyles and all of that, it's like, you know what I mean, you get a bigger respect for your black woman, and you know what I mean, you get to treat the queens even better, because now you get to relate to them a little bit more. But hey, that's all I got today for you all. I don't want this to be a long video. Go check out my curly hair routine video, because if you don't, then you're gonna be on the curl sponge. And if you're on the curl sponge, remember, that's all right. But hey, we're here for excellence. We're here for elegance. You know what I mean? That's all we can get on this channel. All right, guys, that's it for me today. All my social media outlets will be linked in the description below. And if you have not already, hit that subscribe button, because I don't know what you're waiting for if you haven't. It's the only way to become a part of the Elegant Savage fam and stay up to date with all the videos I'll be releasing. That's it for me today, guys. And remember, the elegance comes first.